Hello, everybody. We're going to place another head-to-head game here. So, let's see what... Hopefully, we don't get a mismatch like that last game was, if I remember. Sometimes EA servers just don't want to give you the right match or the right overall you face for some dumb reason. Okay, 10 seconds. Waiting. There we go. All right, let's go. Let's do this. So I was going to do the Santa thing, but I thought it was going to be a little more difficult than it was because the team was a 99 overall on all Madden. I ended up getting it the second time because the L's were so small that Santa couldn't hook up with them deep or anything. But since it was all Madden, it took me on my second try because some reason on that difficulty, even when your quarterback has a perfect pocket, they still make your quarterback throw wild for some dumb reason. And I hate it.
Hey, welcome in, everyone, right, to another edition of the NFL and Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Week one is behind us. It's on to week two, and we've got a good one for you this afternoon.
All right, here we go.
Between the New England Patriots and the Minnesota Vikings. The Patriots come into this one knowing that this could very well turn into a high-scoring affair. So this defense is on notice. They're going to need to be at the...
Oh, go! Out of here with the victory. Yeah! Nice. Bingo. Good start. Good start.
The speed of the returner gets down the field, and after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
First down at the 49.
Oh.
There to make the stop. They must keep an eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side.
So, maybe who's their best guy? Their free safety?
Second and two. Pressure was good.
Nice. See if I can get him with this.
First down here after the run.
Here we go.
Jackson.
It didn't work.
The Vikings guess right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
The line of scrimmage is at the 40.
All right.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Here we go. Wide and yet.
Carr's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Throws the pass. And Ward's there to make the tackle.
The Patriots understand just get whatever yards you can every time you run a play. That's what they do that time. It's a short completion. But look what position it puts them here. In on third down, this is something they can handle.
The Patriots take it from the 33. In on the football and has hold of the ball.
Nice. Haha, fumble.
He's just a good example. When a guy catches a football short, if he can just break that tackle, they can pick up those extra yards. Good job by the quarterback and receiver that time.
Stepping up, ready to go from the 7. That long gain sets them up here on this play. Jackson's hand at the football.
Oh, push. Dang it. I got 3.
One of the most versatile tight ends in the NFL, Delanie Walker.
Yeah, when you say versatile, that explains him very well. He can be a fullback, a wide receiver, a tight end, or somebody that moves around and plays all those positions. Delanie Walker.
Yeah, there we go.
Get position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end. Touchdown.
All right, good stuff.
The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. And now Patterson. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return.
Tony Romo, huh?
Dropping back now into the shotgun. The catch by Hopkins.
Dead out route. Andre Hopkins.
Perfection by the receiver. He made such a sharp cut. He gives himself some space from the defender. And the quarterback puts the football right on target, just short of that first down marker. It's second down and three. Taken down at the 40. Amari Cooper caught a ton of passes in Alabama and was the first wide receiver taken in the 2015 draft. He's ready to come in and play right away in the NFL. He's smooth. He knows how to run routes. And he was the man in Alabama. And that's what you want when you're number one receiver.
And now here's the toss. And he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down.
We're both Rock and Bo Jackson.
Team, he goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances. The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing play here. DeAndre Hopkins with the grab.
Dang it.
Well, as you saw that receiver make the catch.
Yeah, man, might not work.
You cannot throw the football.
All right, let's try some zones.
No such thing. When in doubt, you don't like anything, turn and find him and throw it to him.
First down at the 39. Running right through the trenches. Jackson's taken down at the 33. The Vikings offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. The snap will come at the 33. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. This is third down. The Patriots defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Made.
Well, when you play this type of defense where you play cover three, in other words, you have three defenders playing one in the middle, one right, and one left, well, the weakness of that defense is going to be underneath. So slant patterns, they're pretty easy against this cover three.
Romo's three for three with that completion. The Vikings will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Coming up to the line of scrimmage at the 11.
Get ready. Get ready. 50.
First and 10. And it's grabbed by Bo Jackson. Tackle made by Bird that time.
The Patriots have speed on the defensive side, no doubt about it. I mean, they're backed up. They don't have to worry about it. Players going by them because they're in the red zone, they become even faster. Way to get to the football on that throw and catch, and they stop the play for a short gain.
Romo's now completed four in a row. Bo Jackson brings it in. Burnett's gonna make the tackle.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am gonna gamble that it is a run. They have the courage to throw it. Let them. They do.
Sure, well, I want to run here.
About to snap it. For the
I guess it didn't really matter.
We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. On the way, third down. The foot.
football. Runs it. Touchdown.
In the old days, if you're a quarterback, it was rare to get a pass near the goal line. Nowadays, it's rare for the running back to get a run near the goal line. And the big guy took advantage of it this time. He gets the run near the goal line, and he takes it in for the TD.
Harvin will run this one out. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line.
The Patriots take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing.
All right, let's see here.
It's all about decision making now as they work out of the hurry up offense.
Yeah, it's really up to the quarterback. Make sure to watch the clock. Don't get a sack and don't get tackled in bounds. Make sure you give the message to all your teammates.
I like this decision by the coach to go with the hurry up offense here late in the first half. You can't be worried about making mistakes. Sometimes you got to be aggressive. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. No time to huddle right now. They go right to the hurry-up.
Well, Andy, this hurry-up offense, such a big part of the NFL. So many close games. You better be.
Oh, yeah.
And he heads to the sidelines out of bounds.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
Dang it. Thought maybe you'd get out open. That did not work.
He reads the quarterback, gets a position down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
Gresham's the receiver, sent out wide to the left. Carr standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. A nice grab.
Nice.
I doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
First down by the offense in the red zone, and you're on the defensive side. You don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
First and goal from the one. Flip to the outside.
Same exact play he got the touchdown on me.
A big touchdown right there. They're almost sure to take the lead to the locker room with that score.
All touchdowns are big, man. They're all exciting. They all make you feel great. And right now, the offense, they are feeling great about what they did on that last drive.
Patterson's got a chance to return this one. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line.
The Vikings offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team,
not much.
The talent of the players.
There, we'll go with that.
The coaches helped them out, and they got it done.
Romo lines up in the pistol. The Vikings snap it up at the 26. Airing it out.
Oh,
the defender tips it out.
Got to give the secondary credit. This passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Second and 10. Had it for a moment, but then lost it on the hit.
I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third long situation for the offense, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Third and 10. Screen. Catch made. Still on his feet. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. The Vikings are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. Jackson's in the backfield. Single back set.
Kill.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Got drilled as
All right.
Second down after the incompletion. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. Jackson's the receiver on the screen.
I fell like a moron.
Tackles made.
Darn it.
The first half is complete. Larry Ridley ready to take things over back in the studios, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Patterson will test the coverage. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Vikings talked things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. It's the defense calls the drives. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Patriots will come out in the dime. Second down, 3 for the first.
The frick? And he's tackled. Ah, barely got that.
The Vikings just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
This might catch him off guard, I'm hoping.
Jackson's lined up as the single back.
Nope. No way.
D'Angelo Hall makes the hit.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Romo's completion percentage, 70% on the day.
That'll be 5 yards. Delay of game.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
But it's incomplete.
They went for the at least Jarris Burke there. Keep no, up with him. Unlike my play. Other free safety.
Yeah, you want to do this. You always want to throw the football deep at least 4 or 5 times a game because you want to make the defensive backs uncomfortable. If you let them get comfortable, they'll start jumping those short ones. These guys are going to do that anymore now.
Jackson's met after a gain of 3.
Some reason I don't like that.
The Vikings come to the line. First down marker at the 40. He'll throw it over the middle.
Ah, yes.
Bring it in.
Ah, yes.
Got to get the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are
going for it, I see.
All over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
The Vikings don't want any part of punting the football. They're going to go for it on fourth down. The Patriots defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Oh, you got it. Oh. God dang it.
Vikings, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half.
Nice.
You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Romo's completion percentage, 60% on the day. The Vikings from the 32.
Ah! Oh.
Hands.
Every quarterback hates a situation like this. You're down in the football game, and you got third ball, but you must be thinking, don't turn it over. So don't force the situation by trying to throw one in there in tight coverage. If they're not open, throw it short.
Romo's going to be in the pistol here.
No!
Made by Dwayne Allen.
Are you kidding me? What the frick was that? That was garbage. Wow, that was garbage. Oh.
From the coaches trying to tie this game up. My gosh, some of the play calls were awful. Finally, they relaxed, made some good play calls, and they got this game tied up.
Ross has got it on the return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Patriots' offense is in rhythm. Coming back out for another drive. The last two times they've had it, they found the end zone.
Their rhythm, they're making it look easy. Jim, it's like watching you dance. You have such great rhythm. It looks like you're not even working at it. So that's how it looks for this offense here today.
And it's now second down and five after running it on first down. The Vikings with a nickel look here on defense. Carr's going to take it from the gun.
Oh.
Hold on that time.
Jim, when you look at drop passes in the NFL, it's almost always for the same reason. They take their eyes off the football, the receivers, just before it gets there. And you do that, that little bit of lack of concentration will cause you to drop the pass.
Nice.
It's Fitzgerald. The Patriots take it from the 38. Looking across.
Ah!
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
All right, here we go. Wide and yay! Wide!
Oh, come on! Come on, man. He's dropping it like crazy. Come on.
Hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Alert! Zebra! Zebra!
One last play before the quarter ends.
There we go.
We're about to start the fourth quarter. We're all tied up.
Are you kidding? Oh, what the frick happened? Oh, he caught it. That was picked off. Wow. Nice. Holy crap.
Always manage the football game. You gotta be thinking about it all the time if you're the quarterback. You're down in here in the red zone. Be careful with the football. You at least want to get 3 points out of this.
Stepping up to the line at the 6-yard line. Press coverage all the way.
All right, here
the
we go.
Vikings Red defense team. Now is going to go nickel. Team. Second and goal from the 6.
Dude, he didn't throw it. I pressed the freaking button like 3 seconds before. Come on. Oh, come on, man.
And he takes a huge sack.
Time is running out. The game is tied. And the defense must do whatever it can to not give up a score.
Yes. There we go.
And they got an early fourth quarter lead after that touchdown.
Yeah, I know it's early in the fourth quarter, but that is a big deal. When you talk about the fourth quarter, that's when players start looking at the clock and how much time is left in the game. And, of course, that goes without saying, so the coaches.
The 23. The Vikings offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
First down at the 23. Toss to the outside. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
That was a good idea that time by the offensive coordinator. Trying to go with the run game here in the fourth quarter when they're only down one score. D defense was ready and stops it for a short gain.
Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win.
He's wide open for the grab.
The Vikings did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Romo's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play.
And here we have second down. This game is not over, but the quarterback knows that time is short, and his team must do something in a hurry.
Allen's got
Dang it.
On a pass, had some heat on it.
They're going to the hurry. The Vikings take it from the 43. Complete to Allen.
Gain 15.
Third catch today so far.
Nice catch that time by the receiver on the slant route. Quarterback puts it right on target.
2 minutes remaining, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down, pressure on every snap now. Just about 2 minutes to go, and the defense knows it needs to make one last stop to end it.
Almost, that was almost the game.
Second down, late in the fourth quarter. The Patriots at the line. Dime package. The Vikings take it from the 28. Jackson's out there to receive the screen pass. Jackson's marked down after a gain of 9. Phil, it's third down. They are in 4-down territory, and the defense knows that.
Yeah, and you get a situation like this, Jim, on the defensive side, you need one of your pass rushers to come through and get on that quarterback.
A huge third down play on the way. Jackson's lined up in a single back formation. Throws the pass.
That time the defense was ready. Third and short. They were expecting pass. And that's what they got. And the pass is incomplete.
All right, I got to get a stop here. Or anything, he may go for a slant. Need to try to pick something here to avoid that. Try to cover two crests.
Still on the field right now. Fourth down, and they'll need to pick up two. Crucial play here. Fourth down on the way.
Oh, yes!
And Grimes is the one who made the big stop. Romo's unable to come through on fourth down, and with that failed possession, they may
I need to get a first down here to end the game here. Come on! These guys need to freaking hold on to their blocks, man. God!
That leads us to second down. The Vikings lined up in the nickel.
All right, here we go. Wide and yay!
Jackson's gonna take the handoff now.
That's just the right call to make in this situation. Just run the football. Don't try to be some genius and catch the defense off guard. Manage the clock and just get this game over with.
The Patriots come to the line. First down marker is at the 32. Jackson's ready to run off the screen. Fights through contact.
Holy crap, go! Bo Jackson! Yeah!
What a play!
Well, that touchdown just put the icing on the cake, Jim. Whatever you want to say, because now the lead's too big, not enough time for the other team to come back. Great job by the offense.
Mason Crosby ready for the kickoff. Patterson. Patterson's going to test the coverage here. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24.
Probably got to try to get along now.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. The Patriots with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Cooper's got it on a pass.
Really? Oh, come on, man.
The 10 in stride, and he's home for the touchdown. Late in the fourth, and even after that touchdown, they're going to need a miracle in the closing moments.
Well, I think what we're finding out, the game is never over. Play it till the end. They did a great job of scoring there. Now can they find a way to get that football back and maybe win this game?
That's smart, bro. Oh, why the freak?
Harmon's gonna test the coverage this time. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line.
I have no idea why he didn't go for an onside kick there.
They're looking to kneel this game out. How great a feeling was it to take the
field? What an idiot. Could have went for an onside kick, bro.
You get in the huddle, you can smile each other, but the one thing you do talk about, Jim, make sure you protect the quarterback and don't let somebody come in and get a cheap hit on him before he can kneel down and end this game.
I don't know why. I don't know. Probably hoping I'd throw it. Here, I'll throw it long here.
The Vikings defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. They're gonna get him here for a sack.
That's what all defensive coordinators love to see, when they don't have to blitz and one of their defensive linemen gets a sack without any blitzing.
This was a close one. It came down to the wire. What's that feeling?
All
right.
Good game.
Oh, it's awesome. When games are close, you're down on the
sideline. Even though my defense really did not do much.
I hope we can find a way to win this game today. They did it. It is truly extremely exciting once you get it done.
All right. Nice.
So for Bill Sims and all the crew at EA.